Hey all, welcome back to homeschool and I am back with the chapter Magnetic Effect of Electric Current and this is our 7th video on a chapter. If you want to watch the previous 6 videos, links are provided in the description area where you can go and watch. You would definitely get a detailed and clear explanation about various concepts. Okay. And today, I am with one more wonderful concept which is very, very important. And because of this, you know, many inventions have been observed in the field of physics. Okay, so I think I can say this particular topic and the invention of this particular concept is a breakthrough in the field of physics. Okay, so what is the topic? I think it's there right on a board. That is electromagnetic induction. Yeah, so electromagnetic induction is seriously a wonderful invention which is done by a scientist called Michael Faraday. Yeah, anyway, let us go in deep about a concept of electromagnetic induction. Before that, let us try to recall what and all we studied so far. See, very famous scientist called Hans Christian Oersted. He said that whenever a current is carried in a conductor, magnetic field is generated. This is what the chapter is all about, right? Fine. And we also have seen that whatever may be the shape of a conductor, conductor can be a straight conductor, it can be a circular loop, or it can be a solenoid. Okay, say whatever may be the shape, whenever current is passed through a conductor, definitely magnetic field gets generated. All that we have discussed. So there we have discussed right hand thumb rule, right? And after that, one more important thing we observed is whenever this current carrying conductor is kept near a magnet, a permanent magnet, this conductor will experience a force. Due to the force, displacement in the conductor takes place. So all that we have discussed, and DC motor actually works on this particular principle, right? So whenever a current carrying conductor is kept near a magnet, it will experience a force. Due to the force, displacement in the conductor, motion or movement of conductor takes place. Right, and there we studied Fleming's left hand rule. So all that is over, and DC motor, which exactly works on the Fleming's left hand rule, everything is over. And now, electromagnetic induction is the opposite of what we have studied is possible. What do you mean by opposite? Say here, when current was moving, magnetic field generated. In the same way, is it possible to generate electricity when magnetic field was moving? Understand carefully. When magnetic field was moving, when I continuously move the magnets near a conductor, automatically can electricity created in a conductor? Definitely yes. That is what we mean by electromagnetic induction. That is what we are going to study in detail in today's session. So definitely the session is going to be a wonderful thing. So listen carefully with utmost concentration so that you get complete idea and the complete clarity on a concept. Yeah. See, first and foremost, I am going with one simple experiment. Clear? And before that, let me tell you something about a scientist who invented this electromagnetic induction. He is nothing but Faraday. Remember the name? Michael Faraday. It's a very famous scientist. Not only electromagnetic induction, he actually invented many things in the field of physics. Okay, so which we are constantly using his inventions in day-to-day life for our benefits. Clear? So as you go for higher classes, you would see more things, more inventions by this person called Michael Faraday. And as of now, just try to remember, he is the one who actually invented this particular concept, that is electromagnetic induction. Okay, so let us understand the concept with one particular activity, right? Activity, or I can say it is the experiment, and this is actually mentioned in your NCERT textbook. So let us study them in detail, right? Activity one or experiment one. See, what Michael Faraday initially took was, he actually took a coil, insulated copper coil, I can say. And this particular coil, you know, he did not connect it to a battery. Instead of that, he connected this to galvanometer. He just connected to galvanometer. So now the question is, what do you mean by galvanometer? See, galvanometer actually will detect the presence of current in a circuit. Okay, so what will a galvanometer do? Galvanometer detects the presence of current. Okay, whether current is there or not can be detected by galvanometer. And what is ammeter that we have studied many times? Ammeter measures the amount of current that is there in a circuit. Ammeter exactly gives a value that how much amount of current is there in a circuit. But galvanometer is the one which is used to detect whether current is there or not. Okay, it is helpful in saying whether current is getting passed in a circuit or not. That's it. Okay, so it will not actually measure the exact amount of current present in a circuit. So that work is actually done by ammeter. Right? So what did he do? He took a copper coil and the ends of this he connected to galvanometer. Okay, so he is doing some experiment. With that, he is trying to observe whether current can automatically be produced in a circuit or not without the help of a battery. If battery was there, definitely current will pass, right? But here, no battery, nothing. He is trying to observe how current is getting generated here. So he took this particular setup and he took a magnet, one bar magnet, which is having a north pole and a south pole. So when he kept a magnet near to a coil, and when he kept a copper coil with a galvanometer, he is not moving anything. Okay, both the setup, both the instruments are stationary. Stationary in the sense they are not moving. Did he observe a current? Did he observe a deflection in a galvanometer? No. Okay, if current was there, you know, galvanometer will undergo a certain level of deflection. See, here certain values would be there. This is exactly where the pointer of galvanometer is present. If there is a current, you know, this pointer would deflect either to the right side or to the left side, right? So this particular guy, okay, when he kept a setup stationary, there is no deflection in a galvanometer. That means there is no current. And now what this person, Faraday, has done is, he brought the magnet near to the coil. Okay, he brought the magnet near to the coil. Okay, he moved the magnet near to the coil. And suddenly he found a deflection. He found a deflection of a pointer towards right side. Okay, so let me mention the points here. When magnet brought near to the coil, what did he observe? What did he observe, guys? He observed deflection. Deflection towards right. Towards right. In galvanometer. G in the sense galvanometer. Right? This is the first observation. And now, he kept the magnet like that only. Okay? He did not move. He just moved near to the coil, he observed a deflection. When he stopped moving the magnet, no, there was no deflection. Again, what did he do? He moved the magnet far away. He took the magnet far away. Okay, again he started moving the magnet, but now not towards the coil. He started moving the magnet away from the coil. Okay, then also deflection was seen. Okay, then also deflection was seen, and the deflection was towards the left side. Okay, previously it was to the right side. Now the deflection is towards the left side. So let us write. When magnet moved away from the coil, okay, what happened here? Deflection towards left side in galvanometer is observed. Clear, right, everybody? Fine. But when he kept the magnet stationary, okay, there was no deflection. That point also try to write down. When magnet was stationary in the sense, he did not move it, he kept it like that only. What you would observe? You would observe no deflection in galvanometer. Okay. And now what he has done is he interchanged the poles. Okay. He brought the south pole near to the magnet. He just interchanged the poles and he started moving the magnet towards the coil. Did he observe the deflection? Definitely yes. Okay. So what I will write here, when poles were interchanged, deflection was observed, but in opposite direction compared to the previous case. See here, when north pole was brought near to the coil, to which side deflection took place? Right side in a galvanometer. Now, when south pole of a magnet brought near to the coil, deflection takes place to the left side. When north pole was brought near, deflection took place towards right side. When south pole was brought near, deflection will take place to the left side. That is in opposite direction. Okay. Similarly, when he started moving the magnet away, okay, south pole here, north pole here, the same magnet he started moving away. Then also he observed a deflection in the galvanometer. Clear? But when he kept the magnet stationary, there was no deflection. So what does this mean? This means that definitely magnet will have a field lines. Yes or no? Magnetic field will be there around the magnet. When you change the magnetic field continuously near a conducting coil, you know what happens? Electricity is generated in the coil. That's the reason galvanometer is deflected. Okay, so when the magnet is stationary, there was no deflection. That means when the magnet is stationary, its magnetic field will remain as it is. It will not change, right? It will not change near a coil. When magnet continuously moves, you would observe change in the magnetic field. That continuous change in the magnetic field is necessary to bring the voltage in this particular conductor. Okay, got to know? See, when the magnet is very near, more magnetic field is experienced by the conductor. When the magnet is very far away, less magnetic field is experienced. That change in the magnetic field should be there. Continuously, same amount of magnetic field must not be there near the conductor. Okay, conductor should experience different amount of magnetic field continuously over a period of time. Only then voltage is generated in the circuit or conductor. Okay, so this is what we mean by electromagnetic induction, guys. When there is a change in the magnetic field around certain conductor, okay, voltage is induced in that, current is generated in that conductor. Okay, so this is what electromagnetic induction. Fine. So far what we have seen is, when magnet was moved near and away, deflection was seen. If I keep the magnet stationary, I will start moving the coil here and there. Do I observe deflection in the galvanometer? Do I observe current getting produced in the coil? Definitely yes, guys. Even if you keep, when you keep a magnet stationary, but you are moving coil here and there, no? That means the coil is experiencing different magnetic field, varied magnetic field. Definitely there is a change in the magnetic field in various position. So when coil is moved here and there, keeping magnet stationary, then also you will observe a deflection in the galvanometer. Okay, so let us write that point also here. When magnet is stationary, but coil is moving, what happens? Deflection is observed in the galvanometer. In the sense, what? When do you observe a deflection in the galvanometer? When there is a current passing in a conductor, right? So this is what the activity that tells you how electricity is created in a conductor when magnetic field is changed near to it. Clear? So let us understand this particular activity with the help of a visual so that you get more clarity.
See guys, for our activity that we have just now seen on a board involves a copper wire. Here is a copper wire that we have taken. This is a conductor, right? And this is our galvanometer, guys. See, this is the instrument that is going to detect whether current is there in a conductor or not. Yeah. And then we need a bar magnet also. So these are the things that we need to do this activity: copper coil, galvanometer, bar magnet. And now the copper coil is connected to the ends of a galvanometer. See, galvanometer has like a red wire and a black wire. Red wire is connected to one end of a copper wire, and black wire is connected to another end of a copper wire. So this is a small circuit that we are making here, right? So now, after connecting a copper coil, that's a conductor, to a galvanometer, see the magnet I am bringing near and far. This guy is bringing a magnet near and far. See the deflection in the galvanometer. This is what you have to observe. See the deflection. See, as the magnet moves into the coil and out of the coil, deflection is very clear, right? Deflection is seen. And actually, when the magnet is stationary inside a coil, there is no deflection. See the galvanometer pointer, it is exactly at zero. There's no deflection. So magnet, when it is kept stationary, you won't find any current. Deflection is seen in a galvanometer in the sense, what guys? There is current that is produced in this conductor, right? And now, I will change the pole of the magnet. Now, see, poles are changed. Before it was a south pole moving, now it's a north pole moving. Then also you would see the deflection, right? And now I keep the magnet stationary and I will move the coil. Then also you would find a deflection in a galvanometer, right? So here, carefully observe one thing. When I move magnet towards the coil and away the coil, you have seen a deflection. And when coil is moved towards a magnet, magnet was stationary, coil has moved towards a magnet and away the magnet, you have seen a deflection. When both are stationary, okay, when both were not moving, you did not see the deflection, right? So this is what we mean by electromagnetic induction. So when there is a movement of a coil or magnet, that means you are bringing a change in the magnetic field, right? And this magnetic field change is inducing a current in a conductor.
Okay. So after watching a visual and listening to an explanation, what is the conclusion that you can give for activity one? See, the conclusion is very simple, guys. Whenever there is a change in the magnetic field, change in the magnetic field can be created by the moment of magnet or by the moment of conductor's position also. Okay, you will observe the potential difference getting generated in a conductor. When there is a potential difference, electricity would be passed. Yes or no? So potential difference generated in the conductor is nothing but current is getting generated. So this is what the conclusion we have seen. And also, when both coil and magnet are stationary, there is no electricity produced. So any one of the two things, either a coil or a magnet, should continuously move, right, to bring a change in the magnetic field. So when any one doesn't move continuously, it's like you are not bringing a change in the magnetic field. So any one of them, either a magnet or a coil, should continuously move to observe a change in a magnetic field. Only when there is a change in a magnetic field, you would observe a current getting generated in a circuit, right, or in a conductor. Fine. And now let us see another activity. Activity 2. Observe here, I took one wooden rod. This is some wooden rod, okay? Say, on a wooden rod, at one end, I have a copper coil surrounding it, okay? Which is having more turnings, which has more loops, okay? And this particular copper coil, I will connect to a battery, okay? So, I'll connect this to a battery, right? This is a positive terminal, negative terminal. And, yes, there is a switch. There is a switch. So this is what the coil 1. This is what the coil 1. And the coil 1 is also called as primary coil. This is also called primary coil. Okay. See here. Observe one thing here. Here battery is there, guys. Okay. Battery is there. That means current is flowing from positive end to negative end. Okay, current is flowing from positive end to negative end. So, there is a current flowing in this coil continuously. Already current is there. Fine. And I will take another coil, okay, which is connected to galvanometer. Okay, which is connected to galvanometer. What I am trying to do is, with the help of this primary coil, I'm trying to induce. What do you mean by inducing? Putting something into another. Okay. So, I'm trying to induce or I'm trying to produce electricity in coil 2. Okay. This is our coil 2. Coil 2 is also called as secondary coil here. Secondary coil. So, secondary coil is not having any electricity. Okay, there is no electricity. I just connected to galvanometer. Galvanometer was not showing any deflection. That means there is no current in this coil 2. But there is current in the coil 1 because battery is there, switch is there. The moment I on the switch, you know, electricity can pass through the entire circuit. Right? See here. Here can you tell me how an electricity can be produced in the coil 2 with the help of coil 1? There is no magnet here. See, in the previous activity, what you have seen, magnet was there. You continuously moved the magnet or you continuously moved the coil. So, magnetic field around a magnet is changing continuously. What I told you, that change in magnetic field near a conductor will bring electricity in a conductor, I told you. Okay. But you see the setup here, nothing is moving here. And where is the magnetic field? Can you tell me? Magnetic field is necessary for creating a current, right? That magnetic field must be changing continuously. It should change continuously. Okay. So, where is the magnetic field here? See here, the moment I on the switch, electricity will pass into the coil. So, whenever a current carrying conductor is there with you. Magnetic field is generated. That is what the concept we studied in our previous videos and all. Whenever current is passed in a certain conductor, magnetic field is generated. So the moment I on the switch, magnetic field gets generated. Okay. So because of this magnetic field, there can create electricity in a coil too. Okay. So what happens here? When switch is on, you know, in coil one, current flows. If current flows, magnetic field is generated. Okay. So the coil 2 will experience some amount of magnetic field. So automatic deflection is seen in a galvanometer. So what I'll write here? Momentary deflection. Momentary deflection is seen in galvanometer. In galvanometer is observed. Okay, so the moment I on the switch, what happens? The needle of the galvanometer, suddenly it moved. It moved this side and it came back. Okay, galvanometer needle, which was exactly at the center, what happened? It slightly moved. It slightly deflected and it came back. Okay, because when I on the switch, magnetic field is generated. So, this particular coil is experiencing a magnetic field from this coil 1. So, momentary deflection is seen. But after some time, what happens? The magnetic field that is created is as it is. There is no change in the magnetic field. How much amount of magnetic field generated, that much only is there. What if you have to continuously observe the electricity getting passed here? There should be a change in the magnetic field now. But when you continuously on the switch and when you keep it like that, the magnetic field is created. So a momentary deflection initially observed. But you know, after some time, this particular coil will not experience change in magnetic field. That's why the deflection will not be seen. But the moment switch is off, okay, again magnetic field in the coil will fall down. Yes or no? So again this coil will experience the change in the magnetic field. Before there was more magnetic field experienced, now less magnetic field this is experiencing. That means change in the magnetic field is observed. So again a deflection is seen in a galvanometer. Okay, so when the switch is continuously on off when you do, then only you would observe, electricity getting produced in the coil 2. Clear everybody? Switch has to be on off. Okay, when you keep on doing on off thing, only then you would observe a deflection in the galvanometer. When the switch is continuously on, when the switch was on initially, deflection is seen, but after some time, there is no deflection because you will not observe change in the magnetic field. Okay, so either switch has to be continuously on off, or you can use a battery of AC source. AC source, AC current. AC in the sense alternating current. Alternating current in the sense the current will vary periodically. Current will vary according to a time. Okay, so same current direction will change actually. Current's direction will change. So when the current direction is changed, automatically change in the magnetic field keeps happening in a coil. Coil 1. So when there is a change in the magnetic field keeps happening, that's what needed for coil 2, no? To have electricity in this particular thing. Right? So when you use AC source, you would observe change in current. When there is a change in current, change in magnetic field is observed. Okay, when there is a change in the magnetic field continuously, deflection is observed in a galvanometer. That means continuously electricity can get produced in the coil 2. That is our secondary coil. Okay, clear everybody? So change in the magnetic field is very much necessary to create electric current in this particular conductor, that is coil 2. Right, either you have to move magnet continuously to bring that change in magnetic field, or you have to move the coil continuously near a magnet, or you know, this kind of setup you can use where one of the coil is connected to AC source. Okay, see, every time you cannot switch on, switch off, switch on, switch off, right? So AC source, instead of on, off, off switch, I will use AC source where change in current takes place. Whenever there is a change in a current, change in magnetic field is observed. Whenever there is a change in the magnetic field near the coil 2, automatically electricity is produced in coil 2. So these are the three ways of generating electric current with the help of magnetic field. And this is what we mean by electromagnetic induction. So you got some idea, right? So to understand better, let us see a visual on this particular activity also.
See guys, coming to the activity 2, we have a setup here. See, this is one coil, this is another coil. This coil has more turnings, right? And this is connected to a battery and a plug key. And the other coil is connected to a galvanometer, right? And this coil, the coil which is connected to battery, is a primary coil. And the coil which is connected to a galvanometer is called secondary coil, right? We have already discussed this. So what we are going to do is, with the help of a battery, the moment I insert a key, current would flow into the conductor, right? And when current is flowing in a conductor, magnetic field is created, and that magnetic field, in case if it is keeping on changing, that induces current in a secondary coil, right? And now let us see, I will insert a key. The moment I insert a key, you have a momentary deflection, right? You can watch once again. See, a deflection is seen in a galvanometer the moment I inserted a key. That means the moment you insert a key, current would flow in a conductor. So magnetic field would have created, that has induced current in the secondary coil. So you are seeing a deflection in a galvanometer. And now, as the key is kept as it is, you don't see any deflection in a galvanometer, because magnetic field change will not take place. Only if the magnetic field kept on changing, you would see continuous current in the secondary coil, right? And now I will take out the key once again. So when you take out the key, change in the magnetic field is observed. So that can induce a current in the secondary coil, no? We will observe that also. See, observe carefully. When the key is taken out, you have seen a deflection in a galvanometer, right? So every time when you insert a key, you would see a deflection. Every time when you take out a key, you would see a deflection. That means magnetic field should keep on changing. See, that's the reason we can use alternative source here, which produces alternative current. That means current direction changes every time. So when current keeps on changes every time, magnetic field also changes every time. So that change in the magnetic field can induce current in a secondary coil. So this is another way of bringing induced current in a secondary coil. Clear everybody? So see here, every time you put a key and when you take it out a key, you will see a deflection. Or alternating current, when you use continuous deflection, you will see. Okay, so that is what about the activity 2 that is there in your NCERT book.
So guys, what is the definition that you can write for electromagnetic induction after learning these activities? Okay, let's try to write it. See here, when there is a change in a magnetic field, when there is a change in magnetic field of a conductor, okay, this change in magnetic field, this change in magnetic field induces in the sense it brings, induces voltage. Voltage is nothing but potential difference, which is nothing but current, right? Which induces voltage in another conductor, okay, is called electromagnetic induction, that is EMI, electromagnetic induction. right? See, the coil here, since it is connected to battery, electricity is getting produced. When a current carrying conductor is there, magnetic field is generated. It's not that you should use magnet only for magnetic field. You can use current carrying conductor also, right? So this particular coil generates a magnetic field. So when there is a continuous change in the magnitude or amount of magnetic field, you would observe electricity getting produced in another conductor, that is in coil 2, right? So this is what we mean by electromagnetic induction. So normally, guys, to get continuous electricity in a coil 2, it is better if you continuously move the conductor here and there near the magnetic field. Say in a coil 1, you have a magnetic field here, okay? But you should bring continuous change in the amount of magnetic field, okay? Say, how would you bring the change in the magnetic field when you continuously move the coil 2 here and there? Okay, when there is a movement in the coil, when there is a movement in the conductor here and there near a magnetic field, then better electricity, better current you would observe in a conductor. Okay, clear? So, keep that point in mind. And now, observe this setup, guys. See, I am taking two horseshoe magnets. You know, this magnet has a north pole here. And another magnet of south pole. Okay. So magnetic field is there here. Magnetic field is there. In between a magnetic field, I am keeping a conductor. Imagine this is a conductor I kept. Okay. And where I connected this to a galvanometer. So this is my conductor that kept in between a magnetic field. I continuously move this conductor. Okay, so I will move this conductor. I will continuously bring the movement of conductor. Okay, it keeps moving. Definitely, when a conductor is moving in presence of a magnetic field, conductor will experience change in the magnetic field, no? So when the conductor is also at the same position without movement, magnetic field also is there without movement, then there will not be any change in the magnetic field, guys. When there is no change in the magnetic field, you don't observe deflection in the galvanometer. That means no current is produced. Either magnet has to move to bring the change in the magnetic field, or conductor has to be move to bring the change in the magnetic field. Only then current gets generated, currents gets observed in the conductor. Right. So what I'm doing here, I am keeping the magnets stationary. I am moving the conductor here and there. Continuously, I'll start moving the conductor. What you would observe, the conductor will experience change in the magnetic field. Automatically, current gets generated, and that you would see the deflection in the galvanometer. Right. Fine. And now, if I have to find the direction of current generated, that generated current is there, no? Newly created current is there, no? In the conductor, that is called as induced current. What current it is? Induced current. Okay. So, current in the sense it will move in certain direction. So, how do you find the direction of induced current? Okay, you know, if you know the direction of magnetic field, if you know the direction of the movement of conductor, you are moving conductor, no? You will move it in a particular direction, right? So when you know the direction of a movement of conductor, when you know the movement direction of magnetic field, you all know magnetic field always move from north pole to south pole. So when these two directions are known, then definitely you can find the direction of induced current with the help of Fleming's right hand rule. It is not Fleming's left hand rule, guys. What was Fleming's left hand rule? What you can find out using Fleming's left hand rule? You can find out the magnetic force experienced by a conductor when current carrying conductor was kept in a magnetic field, right? If you stretch your left hand, If this is the direction of magnetic field, if this is the direction of current, then the direction of thumb finger will tell you the direction of force generated when current carrying conductor was kept in a magnetic field. That was Fleming's left hand rule. Now I'm talking about Fleming's right hand rule, guys. Using Fleming's right hand rule, what I can find out? I can find out the direction of newly generated electric current in a conductor. How this electric current is generated? When I change the magnetic field continuously around a conductor, that change in magnetic field created electric current. Yes or no? So here, when you know the movement of a conductor, when you know a direction of magnetic field, you can find out the direction of induced current by what? By Fleming's right hand thumb rule. Okay, let us see how we can find out. So we are learning very important rule, Fleming's right hand rule. See, you should not get confused with Fleming's left hand rule and right hand rule. Both speak about two different concepts. Better you compare and study so that you will not get confused. Don't just by heart. Compare, understand the concept and study, guys. Clear? So, what is Fleming's right hand thumb rule? You have to take your right hand now. Okay, same thing. Stretch the three fingers as much as possible. Which are the three fingers? Thumb, forefinger and middle finger. Okay, stretch them as much as possible. Okay, index finger will tell you about the direction of magnetic field. Okay, so magnetic field will move from north to south side, right? If this is the direction of magnetic field, I consider the direction of index finger, okay, the forefinger as the direction of magnetic field, okay? And if my thumb is the direction of movement of conductor, I am continuously moving the conductor now to bring the change in the magnetic field. So, I will move the conductor in certain direction definitely. So, thumb will indicate the direction of the movement of conductor. Then, my middle finger, that is here, the ring finger will give you the direction of induced current. Okay, newly some current has generated, no? It will move in certain direction. So, that direction is given by the middle finger. Okay. So, I repeat once again. If forefinger or the index finger is the direction of magnetic field, if thumb is the direction of movement of conductor, then the middle finger will give you the direction of induced current. Okay. So, let me write the definition here. Stretch the thumb, forefinger and middle finger as much as possible so that they are mutually perpendicular to each other, what do you mean by mutually perpendicular to each other? So when you stretch the three fingers, you know, this finger is perpendicular to this. This is perpendicular to this, right? So this is what, see, thumb is perpendicular to these two. Forefinger is perpendicular to these two. Middle finger is perpendicular to forefinger and thumb. So, all the three fingers are mutually perpendicular to each other, right? Then, forefinger indicates the direction. Let me write. If forefinger indicates the direction of magnetic field, thumb indicates What does the thumb indicates? The direction of movement of conductor or the motion of conductor. Then middle finger gives you the direction of induced current. Gives you the direction of induced current. Okay, so this is your definition for, you know, Fleming's right hand rule, guys. Clear? So, actually, if the direction of the magnetic field and the direction of the movement of conductor is perpendicular to each other, then actually maximum induced current is observed in a conductor. Okay. And now here only let me explain my Fleming's right hand rule to predict the direction of induced current. See, the direction of magnetic field is north to south. Imagine I am moving a conductor in a clockwise direction. I am moving this conductor in a clockwise direction. Imagine this is AB side of a conductor. Okay. So AB side, I am moving in a clockwise direction. So now what is the direction of induced current? Let us check it out. Okay. So here, see, my forefinger indicates the direction of magnetic field, no? Forefinger indicates the direction of magnetic field. Magnetic field is moving from north to south. That means in this direction. So forefinger, I am keeping like this. Thumb indicates the movement of conductor. So conductor is moving clockwise direction. That means, see, A to B. Okay, A to B. Conductor is moving like this. So I'm keeping my forefinger like this, thumb I kept up because the conductor is moving like this. Okay. And what is the position of my middle finger, guys? It is inside. Okay. Inside, in the sense, it is into, current is flowing into the board or into the page. Yes or no? See, magnetic field direction is this, movement of conductor direction is this. So what then, in that case, what is the direction of my middle finger? It is pointing inside. That means current is moving into the page, into the board. That's how you have to give the answer. Okay. So actually current will move like this, right? So A to B, current is moving actually. Okay. So when a coil is moving in a clockwise direction, when magnetic field is moving from north to south, then current actually moves from A to B. So this is how you have to use right hand rule to predict the direction of induced current. Yeah. So this is all about electromagnetic induction. And you know, next we are going to study is about AC generator. That is in my next video. So generator's principle, working principle is this only, electromagnetic induction. So what happens, generator will have a kind of setup where you have a conductor in between a magnetic field. I continuously rotate a conductor, so continuously electricity is getting produced. You know, this is what the principle of generator. You know, we have two types of generator, AC generator and DC generator. Both of them we will discuss in the next video. Meanwhile, try to find out the difference between AC current and DC current. Anyway, I'll tell that in the next video, but still, you know, try to give the difference between AC and DC current. Post it in a comment box. Yeah, your comments mean a lot for us. So do comment and do like our video. Subscribe our channel to learn the concepts in a easiest way and in a detailed way. Thank you so much.